Hello everybody and thank you all for watching to a new episode of How to DIY RC, to the third episode of How to Build an RC Plane with Cardboard, rebuilding my unbreakable $5 trailer plane, the best plane to learn to fly as a beginner pilot. In the first episode we made a wing out of cardboard, and in the last episode we have built a polyhedral wing out of three sections of the main wing that we built in the first episode. And in this third episode of rebuilding my unbreakable $5 trailer plane, we are making the vertical and horizontal stabilizer with a rudder and elevator, of course. And what you need is, of course, another flat sheet of cardboard that is 4 mm thick. And we're gonna use two layers to make it really stiff and strong, similar to multiplex or triplex. First step, we're going to draw the horizontal stabilizer design. And it is 35 centimeters long and it's 10 centimeters wide. And you're gonna make a second mark at 5 centimeters. You're gonna do the same thing on the other side. Then we need to make a second mark at the center of the horizontal stabilizer, and that's at 17.5 centimeters. From the center of the horizontal stabilizer, I'm going to do make a mark 5 centimeters to the left, 5 centimeters to the right. Make a line, and then we're gonna connect this with this mark from 5 centimeters. Do the same on the other side, and this is the outline of your horizontal stabilizer. Now you're gonna do this twice, one time with the grains running horizontal through the cardboard, and the second time with the grains running vertical to the cardboard. And the next step is cutting them out. Now that you have cut out your two horizontal stabilizers, it's time to glue them together. Wood glue has dried out. Now you have a double layer of horizontal elevator that is super stiff, doesn't bend this way, doesn't flex this way, and if you're going to add tape, it's gonna just make it even stiffer, so that's just perfect. And it makes now time to make the elevator. Of course, the elevator will gonna be as long as the horizontal stabilizer. It's 35 centimeters long, and the reason that we made it 5 centimeters wide, a little bit bigger than normal, is because it's always easier to make it shorter afterwards than adding a piece. And then in the next step, we are going to make the vertical stabilizer. And this is the vertical stabilizer design. It's very similar to the horizontal stabilizer. In this case, it's 18 centimeters high. It's again 10 centimeters wide. Then we made a mark at the top at 5 centimeters. And we made a mark down below at 1.5 centimeters or 1 inch. And from that point to the 5 centimeter point, diagonal line, give you your vertical stabilizer design. And then, of course, copy this twice, one time with the grains vertical, the other time with the grains horizontal. And then glue them together. Then we're going to add some pressure weight, and we're just using a bottle full of water. And after 24 hours the wood glue has dried out and the vertical stabilizer is really strong. Now it's time to make the rudder. The rudder design is an exact copy of the vertical stabilizer. It's just as wide, just as high, it's just everything on the same angle. Then we just have to make one little modification for the elevator, because the elevator will be sitting right over here, and every time when you're pulling on the elevator it will go up and will hit the rudder or bind with the rudder. So you have to make a large opening space for it, so that the elevator can move around free without any issue. And this is the final design of your vertical stabilizer and rudder is going to be looking like. And we're just going to be using a single sheet. This is enough for your rudder. And the next step is taping your vertical stabilizer, your rudder, horizontal stabilizer and elevator. I'm just going to do one layer of tape on all of them. Mark the center of the horizontal stabilizer where your rudder is going to be sitting at, and leave that little bit of space free of any tape. Before you're going to tape the elevator, first going to strengthen it up using a popsicle stick and just glue it down in the center of the elevator, just a few mil behind the leading edge, the hinge. That's very important, to stiffen up the elevator before we're going to tape it. Let's dry it out and tape it in. And while the elevator is drying, we have the vertical stabilizer and the rudder taped in. Now we're going to tape them together and make the hinge. An easy way to do that is having the vertical stabilizer on a little box, so you can tape the rudder to the elevator while it's on an angle, and it makes the hinge work a lot easier, a lot smoother. Then we do one layer across the length of the hinge, so make the hinge, make sure it's nice and flat, and then make sure it doesn't bind and there's enough flex in it. And now we're going to make a little incision for our rudder surface control horn. And if you have seen my previous video of how to make a polyhedral wing, then you know the drill. You just use an old servo horn, sticking that through the opening that we made, cut off the excessive piece on the bottom, and then we are putting it on an angle because we're going to use the top hole right at the top, and it should be right on top of that leading edge. of the hinge. And then glue it on with hot glue. I'm making a little bit of a mess, but we're also going to do the bottom side. So we are really sure that the horn will never come out again. And this is then the end product. It doesn't look pretty, but it works and it stays in a place and it's very easy and cheap to make. So let's continue now with the horizontal stabilizer and elevator. In this step we are going to make the hinge to the horizontal stabilizer. You can see that we already have added some extra support to the elevator with a popsicle stick. And it's going to be on the underside and as close to the horizontal stabilizer as possible. I'm going to be using two rolls of tape as a support under the horizontal stabilizer so we can make the elevator hinge. Marking the center makes it of course easy. We can add the hinge while having the elevator on an angle. I always add four supports and then do the long horizontal. Just need to be precise. And with the elevator on an angle, as smooth as possible. And we got a good functional elevator that doesn't bind anyway and can get a lot of angle. And now it's time for the servo control horn. And making the servo horn is pretty easy, you know the drill. There's only one little issue that you have to keep in mind, because we already made the vertical stabilizer and we have the servo control rod on the left side. That means that the elevator control horn is going to be sitting on the right side. The next and almost final step is adding the horizontal stabilizer with the vertical stabilizer. And we have a little trick using two barbecue sticks. After that we have to poke a hole right close to the top of the horizontal stabilizer. And of course in this step it's very important to have your vertical stabilizer straight on the horizontal stabilizer and also have it straight in all directions. And then if you got that lined up correct, if you have found a place that everything is level, then mark that place with a pen and then poke the hole with your barbecue stick. Now we're going to do the same thing but then on the other side of the vertical stabilizer. So make sure you got everything straight. You're gonna put a thick line of hot glue and then wait to let it dry. Do this on both sides. And now it's time to glue down the barbecue sticks, and you always start first on the horizontal stabilizer until that hardens out and is stiff. Then you go to the top of the vertical stabilizer and make sure everything is lined up nice and straight. And then the finished product should be looking like this and should be really stiff. And this is almost the finished product. The surface is going to be added when we're going to build the body. I really hope that you subscribe for that and click that notification bell so you're not going to miss the new episode that's coming up. And we're going to build the body and we're going over all the electronics and how to find the CG and how to set it up. I rebuilt my $5 training plane from scratch, the best beginner plane to learn to fly with. And I hope that you like it and give it a thumbs up. And thank you all for watching. Goodbye and I hope to see you next time.